We are going to study chapter number 14, a French lesson. Let's first see the main characters. First, Sarah Crewe. She is a pupil, a student in the story. Second, Mariette. Mariette is French maid of Sarah. Third, Miss Minchin. She is Sarah's teacher. Four, Monsieur Dufarge. He is the French master of Sarah, and there is one more character, that is Jessie. She is pupil, she is a student. So let's first understand what is the meaning of the word French. French is a language. Okay, so here in the story, Sarah Crewe, she is a new student in the school. It's her first day in the school. So what happens with her, that we will find out from the story. Now we'll continue the chapter from the textbook.
Before understanding the chapter, let's first understand the meanings. Abashed. Abashed is an adjective, means ashamed. So, when you are ashamed of something, you are abashed. The child felt abashed and promised never to repeat his mistake. So, a child felt ashamed. He was ashamed because of his mistake. And then the child promised that I'll never repeat the mistake. Annoyances. Annoyances is a noun. Something that makes one slightly angry. Something that makes you angry, that thing annoys you. Example, we should not let annoyances affect our work. So, if we get irritated by something or feel annoyed of something, that should not affect our work. We should work properly. Awkward. Awkward is an adjective, means making one feel embarrassed. I feel awkward when the teacher announced my name in the list of latecomers. So, in the example, it is being said that when I came to know that my name was there in the latecomers list and teacher has announced my name, at that time I felt awkward. Bowed. Bowed is a verb. Moved head or top half of the body forward and downward as a sign of respect. So, as a sign of respect, when you bow down, that thing. The little girl bowed before the queen. In the example, it is said that a little girl, she bowed before the queen to give her respect. Ceremoniously is adverb, means by behaving or performing in an extremely formal way. When we behave very formally or we perform something very formally, that is ceremoniously. The entry of the new king was announced ceremoniously. So, the new king is going to come. That thing was announced ceremoniously, means very formally. Concealing. Concealing is verb, means hiding something. When we hide something, we conceal. The boy was concealing the fact that he had failed in the exam. So, the boy was hiding that he had failed in the exam. Curtsy. Curtsy is a formal sign made by a woman to say hello or goodbye by bending her knees with one foot in front of the other. So, a woman, she keeps her one foot and then other foot behind that foot and she bends slightly. This is the way she behaves when she wants to say goodbye or hello to someone. That's a curtsy. The school choir made a curtsy before their performance. The what is the school choir? Choir is a group of students or people who sing together. And so they made a curtsy before their performance. Desirous, adjective, having a wish for something. When you want something, you are desirous. Rahul is desirous of becoming a doctor. So Rahul wants to be a doctor. Dignified, dignified is an adjective, means calm, serious and deserving respect. When you are very calm, very quiet, you are very serious and you should be given respect. At that time you are dignified, means somebody who is respectful. Our school principal has a dignified personality, means our school principal has a very respectful personality. Everyone respects him. Disgrace. Disgrace is a noun, means the loss of other people's respect and approval because of the bad way in which somebody behaved. If someone behaves very badly with you and your respect is gone because of that, you lose your respect, then that thing is disgraceful. His behavior with the guests was an absolute disgrace. So he behaved very badly with the guests, and that's why respect of the guest was lost. Exquisite. Exquisite is an adjective, means something that is extremely beautiful. This painting is an exquisite work of art. So it means this painting is a very beautiful work of art. Flush. Flush is a noun, a red color that appears on one's face because of being ashamed, excited, or feeling hot. So when you are shy and when you feel excited or when you are feeling very hot, at that time what happens? There is a flush, means there is a red color on your face. A pink flush rose to her cheeks when the teacher praised her in the assembly. So when teacher praised one little girl in the assembly, at that time a pink flush rose to her cheeks, means there was a pink flush, there was red color on her cheeks. Glimpse. Glimpse is a noun, means a look at something for a very short time. When you look at something for a very little time, very short time, you glimpse. I caught a glimpse of a shooting star last night. Last night I got a glimpse of a shooting star. Grudge. Grudge is noun, means a feeling of anger or dislike towards somebody because of something bad he or she has done to one in the past. When you know that somebody has done something bad with others in the past, at that time you have a feeling of anger or dislike, that is grudge. It is bad to hold a grudge against anyone. If you hold a grudge, means if you keep anger or dislike for someone in your heart, that is a bad thing. Infuriated means, that's an adjective, it means extremely angry. The student's infuriated reply made him feel guilty. So a student replied very angrily and that made him feel guilty. Wrapped. Wrapped is verb, means heat a hard object or surface several times quickly, making a noise. When you heat something that is hard, or when you heat hard surface a lots of time and that makes a noise, means you wrapped. The teacher wrapped her ruler on the table to draw the attention of the students. So when teacher came into class, she wrapped, means she heat her ruler on the table a lot of times so to get the attention of all students. Sarcasm. Sarcasm is noun, means a way of using words that are the opposite of what one means in order to be unpleasant. So when you want to say something else but you are actually expressing that in words which means opposite to that, at that time that is sarcasm. His speech was full of sarcasm and hence annoyed everyone. When you are angry and you want to say that you are angry, but if someone asks, are you alright, and you reply that no, I am fine. So at that time you actually mean that you are angry or you are annoyed. So this kind of speech is sarcasm. So here in the example it is being said that his speech was full of sarcasm and so everyone was annoyed. Sour. Sour is an adjective, means unpleasant. Though their friendship has turned sour, they still care for each other. So their friendship has turned sour, means it's unpleasant. They are not happy with each other's friendship, but they still care for each other. Stealing a glance. This is an idiom, like muhavra is there in Hindi, something like that. Looking at something or someone quickly so that no one sees you. When you look at something or someone very quickly and you don't want others to notice that, so that is stealing a glance. The teacher punished him for stealing a glance at someone else's answer sheet during the exam. In exam, a student wanted to copy and that's why he had a glance at someone else's paper and teacher punished him for that. Tremendously. Tremendously is an adverb, means extremely. He worked tremendously hard to get a good result. So he worked extremely hard means he worked very hard to get a good result. Threshers are similar words, means the words with similar meanings. Dignified, that is adjective, means magnificent, noble or distinguished. Disgrace is a noun, means dishonor, disrespect or contempt. Glimpse is a noun and means glance, flash, impression. Tremendously, extremely, exceedingly, excessively. So now let's begin with the chapter. Chapter number 14 of French lesson. Given below are some words from the French language. With the help of internet, find out what they mean. So here few words are given in French language and a help box is also given. We have to find the correct answer for that. First one, la mère means mother. La mère, mother. Second, bonjour means hello or good morning. Merci, see R is silent in the third one. Merci means thank you. The story is about Sarah Crewe, a British girl born in India. So Sarah Crewe is the main character of the story. She is a British girl but she was born in India. She was sent to a boarding school in England and then she went to a boarding school. In boarding school, the student has to stay there only, means there is a hostel in which the students stay and they go to the school to study. So let's see what the story is. When Sarah entered the schoolroom the next morning, everybody looked at her with wide, interested eyes. By that time, every pupil had heard a great deal about her. So in the morning, Sarah entered the class. Everyone was looking with surprise at her and they were very interested in knowing that how the newcomer is and what she knows and all those things. Such thing happens when a new student comes to your class also, right? You all want to know that from which school that student has come and what all things that student knows. So before Sarah entered the class, they all were informed that a new student is going to come, and so they all knew quite a lot about her. One or two of them had even caught a glimpse of her French maid Mariette. So one or two of the students had even seen her French maid, whose name was Mariette. "She isn't pretty as other pretty people are," said Jessie, stealing a glance across the room at Sarah. So Jessie, she looked at Sarah very quickly and then she said that she is not very pretty as other French people are, as other people are. "But she makes you want to look at her again." Then she added that she is not very beautiful, very pretty, but you feel like to look at her again. "She has tremendously long eyelashes, but her eyes are almost green." So now Jessie is observing her face and she is saying that her eyelashes are very long and her eyes are green. Sarah was sitting quietly in her seat, waiting to be told what to do. So Sarah is new in the class and she has no idea what she has to do. So she is waiting to get the instructions. She had been placed near Miss Minchin's desk. So Miss Minchin is Sarah's teacher and she was sitting near Miss Minchin's table. She was not abashed at all by the many pairs of eyes watching her. So a lot of students are looking at her and by that she is not ashamed. She is not feeling shy. What happens after this, that we will see in the next video. Thank you.